Summary of the chapter 2. Brookfield was situated across the road behind a rampart of ancient elms. It was named of the valley where it was built. It was established in the reign of Queen Elizabeth as a grammar school. It was unlike Harrow, but a good school of second class in terms of repute and status. The main structure was rebuilt in the reign of the first George, after Napoleonic Wars until mid-Victorian days, that the repute of Brookfield declined. Weatherby joined it in 1840. Brookfield produced fair samples of judges, members of parliament, colonial administrators, peers, bishops, merchants, manufacturers, country squires, and parsons. In his early age, Chips was felt as ambitious as most other young men. He dreamed to get a headship, but he did not get it. He had no private means and family connection of any importance to get headship anywhere in the school. At 40, he was rooted, settled, and quite happy. At 50, he was doyen of the staff. At 60, he became Brookfieldian within a Brookfield. In 1913, at 65, he retired for the first time. He was presented with a check, a writing desk, and a clock at farewell party. A decent career ended quite decently. This is chapter 2. Goodbye, Mr. Chips, a short summary of the chapter.